Our region's business is sponsored by PNC, for the achiever in you. Our region's business, improving our economy, creating jobs, and strengthening communities. Innovation, collaboration, transformation, and the people making it happen. Join us as we take a closer look at our region's business. Now, here's your host, Bill Flanagan.
Today on Our Region's Business, building our future workforce by bringing career opportunities right to the classrooms. Plus, 21 Enable, an initiative that's gaining national recognition for an innovative program to find meaningful employment for young people with disabilities. But first, a story I suspect will get a peep out of you. The Pitt Institute for Entrepreneurial Excellence invited the CEO of an Eastern Pennsylvania company to town to talk about building a family-owned business. So why do those of us in Western Pennsylvania care? Because pretty much everybody here enjoys their products around Easter, if at no other time. The product, of course, Marshmallow Peeps. The company's called Just Born Quality Confections, and Ross Bourne is the CEO. Welcome.
Well, thanks, Bill.
Yeah. Welcome to Pittsburgh.
Well, it's good being here. I will tell you that we make products for every day.
For every day? I know. Well, that's what I was going to ask you, because we all identify the Peeps as something that are in Easter baskets, and you see them everywhere at that time of year. So I was going to ask you, what do you guys do the rest of the year?
Well, Peeps is our most iconic brand.
Sure.
But we're doing Mike and Ike, and here, I even brought you some.
Okay.
Mike and Ike. And we have a sour version, we have original version, and we make hot tamales.
Okay.
Didn't bring those today. And Goldenberg's Peanut Chews, which is a regional favorite, based in Philadelphia. So we have some of that out here, not to the extent that we have it in the eastern part of Pennsylvania, but that's our 100-year-old brand. We
Wow.
bought that company 14 years ago, but the brand is 100 years old.
So a lot of tradition at the company, too, because Just Born itself goes back to, what, to the 1920s or 30s?
Yeah, we're 94 years old.
Okay.
My grandfather started the business in Brooklyn, New York. He was a Russian immigrant. Very interesting story about my grandfather. He was a rabbinical student in the former Soviet Union. It was way back when in the late 1800s, early 1900s.
The Tsarist Russia,
yes,
right?
And
yeah,
he didn't
sure.
want to fight in the war. Tsar had all kinds of things going on, and he left. My grandfather left and headed to Prague and then to Paris. He needed a job, and he got a job in a candy store. He was a clerk for a very short time. Fortunately, he knew French, and he understood how to make candy. He learned quickly, and then he became a candy consultant after being a clerk in the candy store, and learned how to make French chocolates. When he got to this country, he left not too, he didn't spend a lot of time in Paris. When he left and made his way to New York, what he had no money, as most had no money
sure.
Coming in. And he had this knowledge of making French chocolates, and he set up a little shop in New York City and started making product and had a retail establishment. He did a nice job for a period of time, but then he decided, long story, but he decided that he was going to just stick to the manufacturing. In 1923, set up Just Manufacturing in Brooklyn.
Okay, and that was really the beginning of what is today Just Born.
Today,
pretty amazing.
Right.
When did the Peeps come along?
Peeps was 1953. That was a company that actually had the Peep brand, which really wasn't much of a brand in those days. It was a small company based in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, called Rada Candy Company. And they were famous for their jelly beans. And
okay.
So my grandfather, his two brothers-in-law, and my dad was in the business at that point, so
okay.
four of them decided that they were going to buy this Rada Candy Company, not for the building, which had been Milton Hershey's first factory, by the
wow,
way.
Wow, it's all interwoven
very
here,
interwoven
this story.
With candy.
Yeah, it's a great Pennsylvania story, sure.
That they brought the ideas to, and some of the equipment to Bethlehem, where we're based, making jelly beans. Rada was a regional brand. And they also had some hollow mold chocolate, which we didn't take on. And they had a little operation that was making marshmallow shapes by hand out of pastry bags.
Wow.
Women, and they were women, I don't think there were any men involved in squeezing marshmallow out of pastry bags to make different shapes. They were famous for their famous. They, it was a very local and maybe a little bit of regional company making strawberry shortcake, hot dogs, things that looked like a hot dog. It was made out of marshmallow.
Okay.
And they were making some marshmallow chicks by hand and some other things. My dad, as an engineer, decided he could mechanize the process, and that was a really gave us a start into the marshmallow production of Easter.
And so that's, and I got to ask, every Easter, how many peeps do you make? I mean, using those mechanized processes, it's got to be a lot different than it would have been in the handmade days.
It is. Well, it's a lot different than it was even just a few years ago. Okay. We have a lot of automation now, and we're getting more. Hmm. In fact, we're ready to sign up for another major automation packaging line, dealing, by the way, with a company that's not all that too far from our plant, which is wonderful. We don't have to deal with folks in not that we don't like folks in Germany and Italy, and
we're buying local automation and robotics. Yeah,
but we're doing about 5 to 6 million peep shapes a day.
A day?
Every day.
Wow, that's impressive. Yeah, was it a foregone conclusion you'd wind up in the candy business?
Not at all.
No.
I didn't have any reason not to go in because my dad would come home from work and he had enjoyable days. So I was talking to some family business people about how we have to all be thinking about what we talk about and how we behave when we go home at night. If we're tired and we're aggravated and we're complaining about work, why would any child want to go into that profession? I don't care if it's being a teacher or a doctor, anything. My father always came home pretty good shape. He enjoyed his work. I wanted to be a doctor. My grandfather was a doctor, my maternal grandfather, and I was very interested in medicine. I won't go into the long story. I ended up being a lawyer.
Okay. So you did have another career path here.
I really wanted to practice law.
But a really good lesson, and we're just about out of time, of the importance, if you want to carry on a business to the next generation, the attitude the current generation has about that business
Absolutely.
Is really important.
It's right? so key.
Yeah.
It's so key. So I ended up, I was ready to practice law, and but my dad called me and said, look, we're going to be selling the business unless you and your cousin want to come in. Wow. And guess what? We decided to come in, and next week, I will have been working with my cousin for 39 years.
That's incredible. Incredible all the way around. We could keep going. I wish we had more time, but this is fun. I'm so glad we got to meet the guy who delivers all those peeps and all these other candies.
Well, thanks, Bill.
Every year. Great to meet you, Ross. Thank you so much.
Nice
Appreciate
being with
it.
You.
Yeah. Next up, a new effort to bring career education into classrooms across our region as a way to better prepare our future workforce. Stay with us.